same change in the power. Depends on the area the change occurs. Adaku, I don't want to go into detail. Considering how she was able to know that the two of us were talking about Lusana the last time.
My sin. And when has it been the duty of both of you to manage the princess' way of life?
Hey! Adaku, who invited you? And what made you think that we are both discussing about the princess?
Who else called the both of you the last time? We're talking to Lusana. Who else?
I said it, Ekunmiyoku. Now I know we have a traitor among us! Yes!
You have your mouth, so you can say whatever you want to say with it. Anyway, Princess Taima just called, and she said the both of you should fix up Lutana's room immediately.
In their spirit. Hey! You know what I'm saying is not part of the truth. I told you that this girl, let me ask you, are we all not working for Lutana? Why must it be the two of us that will arrange his room? Name. If you ask me, who will I ask? The way both of them are talking shows that there is something intimate beyond just being a personal guy.
Please,
don't put me in trouble. See, at this point, we just all know about things we're going to do. I'm going to do what the princess asked us to do. You know how she behaves. If she comes down and gets us doing another thing, hey, she'll start yelling like an untrained dog. Please, you know the war has ears. Be focused. Please, don't control. Wait. Imagine Uju. Uju of yesterday.
Leave Uju for me. Leave Uju for me.
In this palace.
Leave her. Let's continue.
Finally, the rejected stone has become the chief cornerstone.
Chizoba, I don't understand what you're saying. I told you my father made me my personal guard, and that's all.
He goes wherever you go to, right? He stays wherever you are. Remember, he's still a young, vibrant guy.
So?
Before you know it, emotions will begin to grow. Then the next thing I'll hear is, Chizoba, so I think he's such a cute and responsible guy.
I'm trying to understand the reason I am here to see you. And you're talking about that young man. Zoba, I'm suspecting you. Don't tell me you've got your eyes on that man.
Wait, my princess. Are you kidding me right now?
No, I'm not.
You know I have no such time.
You've been talking about him all day and all. I don't understand.
I was only sympathizing with the guy. How you treated him at the hospital. It was so appalling. I don't go lie, I'll be your friend now. Let me go tell you the truth.
We are over that issue now. We are over it, aren't we?
Yeah, she said.
I am not here for that anyways, but partly for it.
You see, Zoba is not totally wrong.
Zoba, will you come let me whisper, Joe?
Can't you say, nobody's here? Okay, don't worry.
Zoba, don't say anything. Don't just say anything. Don't say anything. Don't laugh. Zoba, don't say anything.
Sorry.
Which kind of face be this one? Chihuahua. Why are you carrying your face like a rotten mango? What happened?
Wait, make her ask both of them. What is that guy feeling like? That guy that is feeling like King Kong and Superman. What is he feeling like?
Who are you talking about?
Wait, are you trying to tell me that you don't know what is going on? Are both of you not in this palace? From my observation, that guy is a snitch. A total snitch. His plan in this palace is to walk us out and become Igwe's chief guard. And it will not work. I, Chihuahua, is here to declare that no Jupiter will make it work. In case you should go and tell him that I said so.
Oh. Do you know that this guy is a stupid person? He's talking about Lotana.
Is he jealous of you?
Wait, who else should we be talking about?
Lotana. Is that why you are wearing the face of a soured grape?
See, human beings, I thought that we are my friends. Oh, people are two-faced. I thought that we are together. I don't know that you have sold your soul to the devil. Huh?
Look, let me tell you. If you want to be my friend, stop snitching around and mind your business. I'm not a psychophant like you.
You're speaking English. Stop snitching around and mind your bitches. You're a psychophant. In fact, you are a nincompoop. Huh? You are a psychophant and a nincompoop.
Chihuahua. Chihuahua. You are just a dog. Do not dare a lion, else you will be devoured.
Look at the lion. Dead lion. A dog is better than a dead lion. A dog is bigger than a dead lion.
I've warned you.
Jobless human beings.
Come, stop pouring Mr. Saliva. So go to where you were going to.
Chihuahua is not like
get people. Out.
You get in. Stupid idiot. Get out.
Look at the shape of your head.
Best of the same feather. Nikon.
This guy is a jealous human being.
Very stupid.
See where your mind go, Lutala.
You want to be mad? Hey! Check balance, guy. Don't mind your business.
Chihuahua, are you deaf? How many times do you want me to call you before you answer?
I'm sorry, my princess. I didn't hear you earlier.
I thought I asked you to wash my car.
Your car? I thought you told Lieutenant to wash your car.
Are you crazy?
No, my princess.
Are you mad? Which of them have you become? I asked, are you crazy?
No, my princess.
But my princess, I was there.
Shut up. My leniency and simplicity has contributed to the exhibition of your extreme madness in this palace. Continue until I become my officials.
I'm sorry, my princess.
5 minutes to clean up the car.
Chihuahua, just clean the car, okay?
Wash what? What's that guy doing in his palace?
Just do it. You have to do it, okay?
Fisherman dragged my own fiancé with me. If I told you about it, if I complained to you, I complained to you about this whole thing, but instead you gave me a deaf ear and you promised me that you're going to talk with the princess. After I heard from you, I'm not heard from the princess.
Quiet. What's wrong with you? Listen, I am the Igwe of this community. I rule everyone. You, your father who is the senator, everyone. Listen, whenever you speak to me, speak with reverence, not arrogance. Nonsense.
Igwe. Igwe. God, how can a common fisherman drag my own fiancé with me? How? This is the height of disrespect. The height of disrespect from the king and the princess.
I'd love you to give me a massage. I've been having body pains for a long time now.
Your wish is my command, my princess. Sorry, my princess. I can't go beyond this point.
But you accepted to do the job.
I've done my part. I beg to take my leave.
Lieutenant.
My princess.
What I want you to do with me. Make me feel like a woman.
With all due respect, my princess, this is not part of my job.
Shh. I decide what your job in this palace is. Stop. Hey.
I need to leave this place now.
Gosh. Of it for me. A princess like me, I should have allowed things play gradually. What will he be thinking of me now? I can no longer pride myself before him.
Sent for me, my princess.
May I have some words with you?
If it is about what happened yesterday, it has gone with yesterday.
How do you know about that?
Your countenance told me.
Lotanna, hope I will not be blackmailed.
I have no proof to do that.
Please, will you forgive me? I know I have done worse thing ever.
My princess, you have done nothing worse than what people do in secret. Like I said, let bygone be bygone.
Thank you very much. This means a lot to me. When will you be going to see your mom?
Why do you ask, my princess?
I'm interested. I would love to see her as well.
You are welcome anytime, any day, my princess.
Thank you.
Thanks for your kind gesture the other time. I appreciate it.
It's nothing.
I beg to take my leave, your princess.
You sent for me, Father.
Yes, I did. Kaima. Lotanna has told me everything. What I want from you now is to tell me exactly the despicable behavior and how it happened.
So this guy only deceived me in believing that he got my back. Humans can't be trusted. Now how do I present it to my father?
Kaima?
Father. Father, I'm genuinely sorry. I can't even face you at all. I am sorry for my despicable behavior. I honestly do not know what came over me.
Now you blame the devil for your heinous act. You also know that you're wrong, totally wrong, for insulting Fred.
Did you actually call me here to sit and discuss Fred? Okay. Did you invite me to discuss the issues that I had with Fred or what, Father?
Tell me the issues you had. Other issues. Any issues you had. Tell me about them.
No issues, Father. Not with anyone.
No issues?
No issues.
Can you go ahead and tell me about your clash with Fred? Because the young man is, I mean, he has inundated my phone with calls.
Fred does not have an iota of feelings for me. Fred does not love me, Dad. He only loves the throne. How else do I make you understand that? He's so much engrossed with his quest for power and wealth that he can compromise even his own destiny. That guy does not respect nor love me.
Kaima, I do not understand what you're talking about. I can't tell you that I really know what you're talking about. What I know is that Fred is a perfect gentleman. He comes from a family that's well-bred. He comes from, he is the son of a respected senator of the Federal Republic. Okay? And I tell you, Kaima, you and Fred make a perfect match.
No, Dad. Princess Kaima and Fred, the son of the senator, can never and will never be compatible. Moreover, Dad, those are not my criteria for picking a lifetime partner. That is a lifetime partner, Dad.
Kaima, can you tell me? Can you talk about what those criteria, the criteria you fancy, tell me about them? Before I start thinking that your accident actually is having an effect on you.
It's so hurtful, you know. It's rather too painful that my father constantly, not minding how I feel, reminds me of my past, of all the past, the accident. The very accident that almost took my life. But it's okay. One thing you must know, Dad. I, Chikaima, will not sit and let you manipulate me into making a choice that will destroy my entire life. I will not let you do that to me using my past. Having said that, give me some time. Let me think about it.
You're troubled. What could be the problem?
It is beyond your comprehension, Chihuahua.
My princess, there's nothing I cannot handle. And that's the reason why we're here. No matter what the situation is, I can handle it. I can put it at ease. That's why we're here.
Chihuahua, do you realize that the princess has a personal bodyguard and it is his personal responsibility to care for the princess?
You're speaking English. Personal what? So we that are here that are guards, are we gardeners? Personal bodyguard. So what is it that guy can handle that I cannot handle? Huh? We are here to protect the king and also protect her. You're speaking English, personal bodyguard.
Get lost.
You disappear. No! Get lost! Do you want to fight me? Do you want to fight me?
My princess.
Please, I beg of you. Do not succumb to the pressure from the king. Follow your heart, please.
Like I said before, you people may never understand. My father is the king of this kingdom. He says what he means and means what he says. Hence the reason he prides himself as the Ekweme one of Omoha kingdom. I hope that makes more sense to you now.
Yes, it does, my princess. But you can also make him to believe in what your heart wants.
My father is a very stubborn king. He will never listen to what my heart wants. He will never want what I want. And me following my heart will automatically make me an arch enemy to him. If I follow my father's biddings, I may never find happiness for the rest of my life. So you see, it's complicated.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is, my princess. But you can give it a trial this time. You can. Oh, see, I may be an ordinary palace guard, but my intelligence, it speaks volume.
Yes, I don't have any problem with that. I just hold on, let me. My daughter is here now. Yes.
Father, I would like us to have an important discussion.
See, let me call you back later. Sit here, my daughter.
Thank you, Father.
What will this be? Who is this that's doing this? Come on. Spill it. Spit it out. Let me hear you.
That which troubles me is in your jurisdiction to end.
My jurisdiction? Lies within my power. No. I'm more worried about who is doing this to you. Spirit or human, who is that person? I know what to do to the person. I will tear everything around you, disturbing you, I will tear down. What is happening? Who is the person? I will deal with the person. Come on.
It's you, Father.
Me? How?
Father. I just want to beg you to listen to me.
Talk, I'm here.
You know I'm a good daughter. I've always been. You're proud of me and I know. But one thing that I'm asking of you, I beg of you to grant. Father, you're forcing me to love Fred. And I don't see myself ever loving him again. I am begging you for the sake of my late mother to please allow me make this lifetime decision for myself. Father, don't allow me make mistakes. Mistakes that would destroy me. Mistakes that would destroy your only child. The only one your late wife birthed for you. Father, please.
Kaima. Kaima. The theatrics. The theatrics are too much. You see, sit down first. Sit. We're going to discuss this issue. Come on, hold this. Hold it. Kaima.
Father.
No. The knot was tied and I am a man of integrity, and there is nothing I can do about this now.
King Mbago. The icon of his time. The King of Kings. The one whose integrity matters to him most, even more than the life of his only child.
What?
King Mbago. The father of my youth. One that raised me. The one that has and is still squeezing me so hard to life. You talked about this hotel. And I ask you, Father. I ask you, a king whose integrity reigns amongst all the socialites. That if I ever died as infant, would Fred have remained single for the rest of his life just because I am not there to wife him?
See, Kaima. This is different. This is different. I'm telling you about a family knot that was tied. It's deep. Something that can never be undone. I'm not even sure that any human can undo it. So, I mean, you just have to learn to love him.
That will be over my dead body. That I, Princess Kaima, the daughter of King Mbago, the one of this kingdom, will learn to love Fred. I can never, ever learn to love that monster. My soul, my heart, my body belong to someone else. And you must have to accept.
I think there is something more between Princess Kaima and Lotana, her personal guard. Why are you laughing?
Hey!
Would you?
What do you mean?
As I was doing my personal chores, so I overheard the king scolding the princess for treating Fred badly. And my instinct is telling me that she's connected to Lotana.
Would you? Would you? Uju?
How many times did I call you? Mind what you say with this your mouth. Be careful of what comes out from this your mouth.
Wait, see. As the king was even scolding her, she walked out of the king, which is a mark of dishonor. She even said in her words, my heart belongs to somebody else.
You may be right, too.
You may be right. I am right this time around. I saw her the other day professing love to Lotana at the entrance of her room.
Eh?
Eh?
Who?
Lotana.
Ordinary Lotana.
It's no longer ordinary again, though. No longer ordinary.
He! And what was his response?
He was happy. Who won't be happy to be loved by the pride of Umunoha? Even you two, you'll be happy.
Hey!
Hey!
You see what I told you the other day? I told you that guy, Lotana, is playing his game perfectly well.
Bam.
But you didn't believe me. You're saying it now.
I believe you. I believe you now. After you said all those things, I started doing my research. Ah, and I saw everything myself.
I don't even know where you belong. Eh?
I am everywhere like MTN.
Everywhere you go.
Hey!
Lotana.
Don't say I told you anything, no. I did not say anything, please. Yeah?
Wonders shall never end.
Honorable Senator of the Federal Republic.
My King, good afternoon.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, my Senator. So, how is the house?
Yes, the house is in order. I'm calling to let you know there's a vacancy in Ministry of Petroleum Resources. Well, my King, I'll be giving 2 slots, and I'm apportioning 1 slot to your daughter, my wife to be, Princess Kaima.
That's why I call you Senator of the People, Senator of the Federal Republic. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. So, what are the prerequisites?
My King, there is no prerequisite. I am the prerequisite, and there's no CV, there's no certificate. But if she has any of these, you can present them for parity's sake. That's all.
This is Nigeria! This can only come from a senator. A senator. I thank you very much. Oh, Chukwu Kaima will be delighted to hear this. Thank you very much.
Well, my King, you are welcome.
Thank you. All right, bye.
The princess, you are supposed to order him, not begging him.
Most times you have to apply diplomacy in order to win a war. You must not be confrontational.
Well, I'm not here for you to lecture on morality. I'm here so we can settle our differences.
The difference here is that you, Mr. Fred, is dogged by what you want, not what you need.
See? Princess, without mixing words, you know that I love you so much. And I want you to marry me. I'm so sorry I wasn't there when you needed me the most. I'm sorry about that, but please. Give me this one last chance and I will never mess it up.
The truth is that the vacuum has been filled by another when you left. And you don't expect me to walk him out of my life just like that. do you?
He's a nobody, right? He doesn't count. I love you so much. You know how far we've gone. I'm the son of a serving senator. You don't need a nobody. Princess. Princess! What an insolence. This is the height of disrespect. Me, Fred, the son of Senator Nwachukwu. Igwe must hear this. Nah. Igwe must hear this. Igwe!
Agaba, do you know there's a lot of things happening in this palace that we cannot remove our eyes from them?
Well, what are you talking about?
We are about to witness the biggest wrestling festival of love in this palace.
Seriously?
Yes, now.
Between who?
Between Fred and Lutana. Yeah.
Fred and Lutana. Mm-hmm. What happened? What's the problem?
Now listen. The other day, the princess and Lutana were together. Okay. And all of a sudden, Fred walked in and told Lutana to leave.
For what?
Uh-huh.
Why would he tell Lutana to leave? Is it because Lutana is just an ordinary guard like us?
You see the problem? That's the problem we're facing here. Now, trust Lutana now. The Odogu with us, the Buruburu one, he refused to leave.
Good.
He stood his ground and he said no until the princess decided to beg him to leave.
I trust Lutana. Lutana is not a coward like Chihuahua.
No.
He's a very brave man.
That's how we roll. But,
it's okay.
You know the way we're doing this thing here. So nobody should come and there.
Why not?
Each time you cry, I know there is trouble.
Yes, there is trouble. The whole of trouble, Your Highness. I was with Princess Kaima. I knelt down, I begged her. I wailed, but instead she walked out on me. She told me someone else won her heart. I didn't understand this, Your Highness.
That's not true. She was only pulling your nails.
From all indication, Your Highness, she's very, very serious. She told me herself, someone has won her heart. Yes.
That's a big fallacy. I know my daughter. No one comes here to see her. No one. Well, I'm sorry I have to shout it, but Fred, no one comes here to see my daughter.
All right, Your Highness, if you're insinuating that I am accusing her wrongly, then why don't you send for her? At least for fair hearing.
All right. I'll go up and bring her down myself. Fair enough?
Yes. Fair enough.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Highness. Thank you, Your Highness.
Head of Vigilante and his boys, and get Lotana. Ensure you apprehend him at all cost. Anything that blocks your way, rush it. Did I communicate?
Yes, Your Highness.
Pay in full for the sin of going to tango with my daughter.
He's just coming in, running in like someone who is dressed like someone who is mad.
Mama,
what is it?
Just be careful.
What for? What has he done? What has he done? Help, Chimo. What has he done to me? Where did I buy him? Huh?
Tell your son that he can run, but he can never hide from me.
Okay.
Because I must surely get him.
But what has he done?
Brilliant, shut up! Shut your mouth!
Shut up!
We're coming back for you!
Where is Lotana?
Your Highness, he's nowhere to be found.
And you're looking me in the face to tell me that. Instead of telling me what you're doing to get him.
Igwe, his mother paved way for his escape.
What?
Yes, and I punched her. She fainted.
Oh! So, you punched her on the face and she fainted. I see. See your face. You should be ashamed of yourself. You punched an old woman old enough to be your mother. And you're gloating. Where is your intelligence?
Igwe, I'm sorry. But you gave an instruction. You said we should crush whatever that come on our way in getting Lotana. And I acted based on your instruction, Igwe.
Okay. So you're indicting me. Is that so?
No, Your Highness.
Now before I open my eyes, all of you have disappeared from my sight. Walk. I want Lotana. Move it!
Thanks for your calling me like this. Hope all is well.
All is not well, Zoba.
What is it? Is Fred still disturbing you?
That is very little compared to what I am about to face. Zoba, I am in total mess right now. In very big trouble. I don't know what to do. Please, will you advise me?
Advise you on what? You haven't said anything yet. What am I advising you on?
I was caught on bed with him.
With who?
Lotanna.
What? That's so stupid of you. How could you be that careless not to know that even if you must do something with that guy, you should be outside the palace? Now you've soaked yourself in a mess.
Zoba, please will you stop? I did not call you for you to apportion blames. The deed has been done. Listen, tell me what to do. I know you can actually do something. I am confused.
My princess, how can I help you when the loophole is so obvious? How can I help you?
Zoba, will you stop? Think of something. That's the reason I called, not for you to blame me.
Ah, Princess Kaima, you see this one, I know do and where. I'm not gonna lie to you. You know do and where. You know what? First thing tomorrow morning, I'll come to the palace and see you. For now, I want to go and pick up material from a client like that. You know this big man wife. Let me just go and pick it up. Tomorrow morning I'll come and see you, okay? I cannot come now. I'll come later. Tomorrow morning, first thing tomorrow, I'll come and see you, okay?
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
You have to meet him once it's quiet time and apologize. And while you do that, ensure that your gesture portrays remorse. That's all.
So, it's going to be difficult. I cannot stand his presence. The sight of him scares the hell out of me. The shame of what I did has covered me up.
Then uncover it yourself.
How, Zoba, how?
He's still your father. He's your father. Just go to him and apologize. Okay, his reaction will then tell if there is any need for any other decision. Just try, okay?
Zoba, you know my father. Fine, I will try.
Good. I have to get going now.
Why so early?
I want to go to the shop. I guess I'm not around. I have some things to fix for a customer, please.
Okay, no problems. I'll call you if there is need to.
It's okay. Just try.
Thank you.
Call me if there is need to. No problems. Take care of you.
Good morning. Are you aware that there is something happening between Kai and my daughter and Lutana? Answer me!
Yes, Your Majesty. Yes, Your Majesty.
Yes. So. You are the little influence, bad influence, around and on my daughter.
I'm not just know.
No. Did you say no? Denial.
be found anywhere around my daughter. Do you understand?
Yes, yes, Your Majesty.
Do I make myself clear?
Yes, yes, Your Majesty. My king, but...
Hey, come on! I don't want you to utter another word. Out! Leave! Even the sight of you is revolting to me.
Father, please. Extend your arm of mercy towards me.
Mercy belongs to the obedient, not to prodigals.
You remember the prodigal? You remember the parable of the prodigal son in the Bible? He was forgiven, Father, and even given a better opportunity.
That's parable. Not an actual event, not a real occurrence. Taima, you disgraced me time and time again. Taima, what's the matter with you? Taima, you did the unimaginable. You rejected Fred. Taima, little did I know that you were having an affair with that nonentity, that gold digger. Ah.
Father, Lutana is not a gold digger. You need to know him beyond being a fisherman and the palace god, Father. There is something about him. Something about him that is special and unique. And you need to know that, Father.
Now you listen to me. Kaima, you must reconcile with Fred. See, I'm not going to tell him what happened. Right? No one even needs to know what happened except to tell the person.
Father, you need to know that I have no issues with Fred. But I cannot see myself spend the rest of my life with him. The sight of that man disgusts and irritates me. Do not push me into this, Father. I am begging you.
You've been bewitched. Utterly bewitched by that gold digger.
Lutana did not bewitch me, Father. Something inside of him did. Father, please, forgive Lutana. Allow him back to the palace.
What? I thought you were going to come here sounding remorseful. Now you are asking something that's impossible.
No, there is nothing impossible for the king, for my father. You can make it possible if you want to, father. Please.
Leave my presence. Get out of my sight!
Ogenezi, what is it? Can you just tell me what happened? Can you now tell me what happened?
Mom, please. I need to be left alone. I need space to put myself together.
Son, I am your mother. You are my son. Whatever it is, feel free to tell me. Whatever secret it is, feel free to tell me. I will sell it.
I will tell you when the time is right. For now, I need space. Please. Let me be.
Okay. Did you fight? Did you argue with anyone? Why are you here? Why did you come back?
Mama, Ebojelumba, Anatago. Simple.
Don't worry. When the time is right, I will tell you. For now, please. Just leave me.
One, Lutana, ran out of the palace like a mad dog. Hope all is well.
If you ask me, who will I ask? I even intend asking you. I remember trying to ask Iwoko and Agada, but they wouldn't give me listening ears. So you tell us, you are the minister of information. So tell us.
Also, minister of information. Two, the king asked that Lutana should be chased away. I asked Iwoko. You see, it doesn't have the clue of what is going on. Make her ask.
It is so strange. Only the Princess Taima and Igwe knows about it. Oh, Pakodio, it's somehow.
It's true. It's true. You're right. No wonder Igwe cannot do anything without listening to Princess Kaima. The way Igwe listens to Princess Kaima this time around is actually becoming so strange that even Igwe have to tell Iwoko not allow Princess Kaima to leave the palace without a guard or a maid.
Please come in. I want to tell you.
This one you are whispering and murmuring. Hope was advisive.
As you can see, we are working. I'm sweeping. So I need to go back to my sleeping. I need to be fast.
Oh, you're sweeping and working. Okay. If I see you update, make one. Then I don't fail to share for me.
Go back to your duty.
Make one share update.
Go. Go. Oh, God, go now.
Baba, come. Baba, you want to know everything? Yes?
Good afternoon, Your Highness.
Fred! Fred, sit down.
Thank you, Highness. Sit down.
Your Highness, you called me on phone and you sounded so urgent. I hope all is well.
Fred, all is well. I'm worried for now, man. It's, the proposal you dropped with us concerning the ultra-modern, modern market. Huh? My cabinet and I, we have jawed, we have read, we have gone through thoroughly. We've discussed, and we think that, yes, you can now start.
Igwe, I'm sorry. I had a change of mind. I'm no longer interested.
What? No, no. That's not fair. I'm sure you don't want to put me to ridicule before the community and my chiefs. Eh?
It's not my fault, Igwe. It's not my fault.
So, it's my fault?
No, Igwe. I never said so. Igwe, I was emotionally traumatized. And the cause was because of Princess Kaima. I told my father to give your daughter a slot out of the two slots from the Ministry of Petroleum. What did I get in return? Rejection. I'm sorry, Your Highness, I had to change my mind.
Fred. Fred. Enweru lu iwe balonuwa. Anger. Anger does not fetch us anything meaningful. Hmm? Yes. See, a chicken, a hen, gathers its food from left, from right, and all around heaps food. And then, in a fit of an anger, begins to scatter. Fiam, 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 fiam. Fred. Will it go hungry? Yeah, come on. I know where your anger is coming from. I know where your grief is coming from. Fred, Kaima is my daughter, and I know how to handle her. I assure you that.
So why you're here, Nessa?
Juwa, my princess. You are the most trusted maiden in this palace. Can I trust you?
Yes, my princess.
Have you ever loved? Have you ever loved someone so much before? Like, have you fell in love before?
Yeah. No, my princess.
I am asking something. Have, Juma, listen. Have you ever loved someone so much that you cannot do without him? Have you ever loved someone so much that...
Majesty.
Uju,
Majesty.
Get out.
Greetings, Father.
Kai Machuku. Why have you chosen to disgrace me?
I don't understand. How do you mean, Father?
Kaima, what has Fred not done for you? What? Listen, Kaima. Fred will take very good care of you if he marries you.
The question should be, what has Fred not done for me? If Fred marries me, Father, he will not and cannot take good care of me. The accident error confirmed it.
Asege. Okputu wa asege. At the insistence of Fred, his father gave you appointment with the Federal Ministry of Petroleum Resources. Fred himself has come into this community now to give us an ultra-modern market. What is it that he hasn't done for us? We're all beneficiaries of that.
And for that, my father is selling me off for the good of the community. From inception, Father, my life, my entire existence have been tied to either tradition or affluence. But that must stop. Henceforth, whatever it is that does not matter to me will not ruin my happiness.
Kaima, don't be ridiculous.
Come on, Father. Come on. I am hell-bent on my decision.
Now listen. Fred will marry you.
I will marry Lutana.
Say you are pregnant for who?
Lutana.
Mm-hmm.
the father of my youth. A king that raised me even without my mother. The toughest of them all, as a king. I am begging you. I am begging you to accept Lotanda. Accept him as your own. And give us your blessings and support. That is not too much of me to ask.
Ears failing me, or am I hearing correctly? Am I? See, you must get rid of that thing there. Get rid of it immediately. Take it off. Abort it now.
Father, it's my child. Your grandchild, Father. A child of one man. The only one man I've ever loved. That is who you refer to as a thing. It is not fair, Father.
You will not tell me what is fair, whether it is fair, whether it's not fair to call what you have there as a thing, because that's what it is. So abort it. Take it off.
That will be over my dead body. That I abort the child of the only man who gave me life when the doctors failed. The one God used to save me. I will never do that. But if you do not want to accept this child that I am carrying as your grandchild, if you do not want to accept Lotanda as my husband to be, I will have no option than to leave this palace in search of him.
All right. If that's how you want it, then you listen. If you leave this place in search of that riffraff, or any other person for that matter, if you walk out of this place, I will disown you. I will cease to be your father.
So be it, Father. It's your choice to cut all ties with your only child. It is your decision to make.
that you have done.
Iwoku. Iwoku.
I want you to ensure that Kaima does not for any reason leave this palace.
Yes, Your Highness.
Do I make myself clear?
Yes, Your Highness.
So you need to hurry and tell me the reason you sent for me, because I need to hurry back to the palace. I sneaked out.
Well, thank you for a job well done. I called the AllStar, appreciate you with a token. Have it.
No, sir. Sir, I didn't do what I did because of the financial assistance I will get from you. No, I did it because I know how much you love the princess and I want the two of you to be happy.
Yeah, even at that, are you trying to reject my token of appreciation?
I am sorry, sir, but everybody must not live for the money. I did what I did because I know I need to do it. I'm sorry, sir. I need to go back to the palace.
How dare she reject my token of appreciation? This maid must be mad. Very, very mad.
Where have you been? The king has been looking for you.
I stepped out to buy something. Hope everything is fine.
Look, there is a very big problem. The king has given instruction never to allow Princess Kama leave the palace. Eh? He's about to do the wow.
How do we intend to do that?
I don't know. We have to be careful. And next time, please, if you want to go out, make sure you tell me. I don't want this kind of problem again, please. Have fun.
Because whom God has chosen cannot be forgotten. Whom God has blessed from whom can never be stopped. Of the four people, four
people are crying because of the religion.
Be careful, you don't know.